Welcome to Letter of the Week. In this episode, we're going to have a look at the detestable antics of a particular judge. So there was this judge, Donald D. Thompson, who presided in Creek County, Oklahoma. He had a respected career and had been serving the city of Sapulpa, pronouncing judgment on all types of cases, from traffic violations to murders, for over 20 years. He was married with three grown-up children. But it turned out that all was not as it seemed with the Honorable Judge Thompson. It emerged during the 2003 first-degree murder trial of Paula S. Moss that the judge had developed a less than honorable habit to while away the hours that he sat on his bench. During this trial, Detective Mike Reed of the Sapulpa Police Department heard an unusual shh, shh, shh sound during a two-hour-long video of the interview of the murder defendant. Later, as Reed testified, he heard the same noise coming from the judge's bench. Taking a quick sidelong glance from his vantage point on the stand, he was able to notice what looked like a plastic tube protruding from underneath the judge's robes. Reed told his supervisors, Captain Brant Green and Chief of Police Jim Moore, who both acknowledged hearing the same shh, shh, shh sound in the courtroom. During a courtroom recess, the detective and his supervisor decided to investigate the judge's bench, and upon discovering a penis pump stashed underneath the bench, quickly snapped up three photos. But what do you do when you have such evidence against a judge? Reed said he began seeking advice that weekend from Creek County Sheriff Steve Tolliver, Creek County District Judge Joe Sam Vassar, and Creek County District Attorney Max Cook. Chief of Police Jim Moore called the Council of Judicial Complaints in Oklahoma City, and discreet investigations began. Thompson had fired his court reporter, Lisa Foster, and his secretary and bailiff, Zelma Hinman, on the same day in 2003, after he had heard that they had cooperated with the Council on Judicial Complaints investigation into his activities. A hearing was set for August 20th, 2004, accusing Thompson of professional misconduct over a number of charges, including indecent exposure and repeatedly using his penis pump while seated at his bench during trials. And the prosecutor had filed a motion seeking Thompson's immediate removal from the bench. But Thompson submitted his intent to resign as a judge just before that hearing, avoiding being forcibly removed from his position. In his resignation letter, he wrote, "I have greatly enjoyed my public service and offer my gratitude for the public trust reposed in me during the term I served." Thompson went on to give interviews about being framed, making allegations that the Sapulpa sheriff had it in for him because he wouldn't cooperate with the corrupt police. The former judge thought he had dodged a bullet, but he soon learnt it was not so easy to get away with his crimes. But with the judge's denials and accusations of corruption, the case had gotten bigger than little old Creek County. The Oklahoma Attorney General, Drew Edmondson, had filed a complaint against Thompson and appointed the district attorney to see if criminal charges could be filed. Investigators went to work, and in Thompson's old Sapulpa courthouse chambers, they found a second penis pump locked in the bottom drawer of a filing cabinet, mixed in with documents belonging to Thompson, including utility bills in his name. They also found some suspicious-looking stains on the judge's former courtroom chair, carpet, and robe, and took samples for DNA analysis. And when his state-owned computer was examined, they discovered some sexually explicit photos of Thompson and his business partner, Angela McClanahan. In June 2006, Thompson found himself back in the courtroom, but this time on the other side of the bench. Thompson was facing four counts of indecent exposure, which put him at risk of a 10-year prison sentence. The trial lasted nearly 3 weeks, during which all the sordid details of the former judge's conduct came to light. The defense attorney, Clark Brewster, failed to totally convince the judge to suppress some of the suggestive sexual language, pornographic photographs, and the penis pump from the jurors. The judge ruled the public had a right to know, and the media had a right to report, The defence attorney argued that Thompson never performed any of these genital-related acts in the courtroom, but it turns out there were multiple witnesses. Two separate court employees testified that they both had seen Thompson place his penis inside of the pump whilst he was presiding over three separate trials, and two of these trials were murder cases. The most disturbing instance was a trial where the defendant was facing murder charges for shaking his girlfriend's 21-month-old daughter to death. As the deceased child's grandfather took the stand and was giving an emotionally charged testimony, he was accompanied by the backing soundtrack of Shh, 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 courtesy of Judge Thompson. Thompson's former court reporter, Lisa Foster, remembered that trial all too well and told the court, "The grandfather was getting really teary-eyed and the judge was up there pumping on that pump. It was sickening."
"It would be silent in the courtroom and he would start in on this pumping sound."
The judge obviously thought he was bulletproof at this stage. The judge was getting so brazen with his behaviour that the sound of the pump could even be heard in the courtroom recordings. Upon questioning, four members of the jury reported hearing the unusual sounds, thinking they might be from an air cushion or the pump of a blood pressure cuff, but a fifth juror said he was sure that the sounds were coming from a penis pump because he was familiar with them from seeing them in some movies.
Orgasmo.
"Did someone say my name?"
The former court reporter, Lisa Foster, told the court that she had seen the judge use the device almost every day during that murder trial. Lisa testified that she saw Thompson expose himself at least 15 times in 2001 and 2003. And she said, "I was really shocked and I was kind of scared because it was so bizarre." Foster said that she felt there were a number of attorneys in the county that knew what Thompson was doing, but she said they were probably just as fearful of Thompson as she was. Along with using the penis pump on the bench, court employees testified that during a trial in 2002, Thompson had also exposed himself and shaved and oiled his private parts, and also put lotion on his penis and urinated in his trash can whilst on the job. Thompson denied any misconduct or wrongdoing whatsoever. However, he did admit to having the pump in the courtroom and that it was a gag gift given to him by a fishing buddy for his 50th birthday, which was 9 years ago. He also admitted that whilst he may have absent-mindedly squeezed the pump whilst on the bench, he never actually used it to masturbate. However, those samples taken of the suspicious fluid found on the judge's robe, chair and carpet came back from the lab identified as semen. Thompson, 59, was convicted on all four felony counts of indecent exposure for the incidents that took place within his Creek County courtroom. The jury recommended a sentence of 1 year in prison and a $10,000 fine on each count. The jury foreman said it was the jury's intent that Thompson serve the full sentence. Prosecutor Patricia High said she was pleased with the outcome, saying the same justice system that he abused held him accountable. And on August 18, 2006, Thompson was indeed sentenced for 4 years in prison, required to register as a sex offender upon release and pay a $40,000 fine. Later that year, he was also suspended from the Bar Association. Supreme Court Justice John Reefe said, "The nature of the crimes in this matter led this court to conclude that nothing less than disbarment is appropriate. The conduct was not isolated, having occurred over a fairly lengthy period of time and on four separate occasions." Thompson was released from prison in 2008 after serving only 20 months, which was less than half of his 48-month sentence. In 2006, the Oklahoma Public Employees Retirement System Board of Trustees discontinued Thompson's monthly $7,789 pension check. Thompson had filed two appeals to have the pension reinstated since then, but ultimately in 2011, the Oklahoma Supreme Court unanimously upheld the lower court's decision that Thompson should lose those benefits. The judge said, The trial resulted in conviction of felonies. Those felonies violated Mr. Thompson's oath of office. But you'd think after all that bad publicity, Thompson would keep his head down and behave. But what did he end up doing? In 2009, Thompson was convicted of actual physical control of a vehicle whilst under the influence. And in 2011, Thompson was charged with driving under the influence, possession of a controlled dangerous substance after a former felony conviction, and possession of a controlled substance without a prescription after a former felony conviction. All of these are felony charges. And you remember that business partner whom Thompson had sexually explicit photos of on his courtroom computer? Well, she's now known as Angela McClanahan Fernandez. And in 2011, Thompson was charged with stalking her. In this mugshot, the damage to Thompson's face was caused by Angela's current boyfriend after Thompson was caught peeping into Angela's bedroom window. Angela had filed a protective order against Thompson on two occasions for stalking her and slashing the tires on her car. Angela had apparently had over 20 instances of tire slashing over the preceding 2 years. Thompson was caught in the act of stalking Angela when she was changing a car tire with the assistance of a police officer. The police confronted Thompson, who was seated in his car staring through binoculars at Angela. When Thompson exited the vehicle, the arresting officer noticed that his pants were unzipped and gaping open. Thompson said, "Oh, I just wanted to see what was going on." So, thus ends the sordid tale of Judge Donald D. Thompson. His antics have caused him to be disbarred, lose his pension, and lose any respectability that he had whatsoever. So thanks for watching, and feel free to leave any comments that you might have in the comment section regarding what you think about this judge's behaviour and whether his punishment was appropriate. And if you have a subject that you think might make a good letter of the week, please feel free to let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.